Hi everyone, my name is Declan McGlynn and welcome to a very, very special Friday Forum Live. Today we're feeling all loved up at a brand new time of 1 p.m. and we're going to be deconstructing the Bee Gees classic, How Deep Is Your Love? So as you can probably tell, we're feeling the love today, but before we get too involved, we're going to have a quick look back at what's been happening this week here at Point Blank. Just today, we launched our brand new first look videos of the Roland TR-8 drum machine and the TB3 bassline synth. And as expected, they're generating a lot of attention and discussion, so make sure you check them out after the broadcast. Plus, our partners III Headphones have launched some brand new TMA1 Stone Throw Edition. Point Blank students get up to 30% off, so make sure you head over to our discounts page on our PB Plus website. And while you're there, check out our new offer. Anyone who books a diploma course with us gets a free home studio, so make sure you check that out too. So Ski, let's get down to some loving. That was really creepy.
How are you feeling today?
Good? I'm feeling good. I'm feeling the love. I mean, these hearts help. But...
Exactly. You can't help but feel love. But you know, there's quite a few love songs around, aren't there, really?
There are a few, yeah.
It's quite a sort of good topic to write a song about, love. Mm. Certainly I turn to that topic when I try and write. We hit on this track just because it's just such an epic tune, you know, so soulful, it's got a kind of real R&B vibe to it. Timeless track, I think. So I just thought, you know, give a few little kind of fun facts about the track. Obviously, you know, I went on Wikipedia, had a little look, and so written and recorded in 1977, a long time ago. I won't tell you how old I was at that time. Written by the Bee Gees, no ghostwriters involved.
I'd take that, wrote this.
Maybe they did, actually. I'll check that out. But what I've got down here is it was Barry, Robin and Morris that wrote it. Cool. And obviously featuring the vocals of Barry. And interesting enough, it was actually intended, as a lot of these songs are, for someone else. Someone called Yvonne Elliman.
Where is she now, you know?
I don't know. What could have been Yvonne? Where could she? I mean, if she had the tune, you know, she could have been massive, but maybe she was at the time. But anyway, then it ended up on Saturday Night Fever.
Of course.
You know, the soundtrack. And it topped the US charts and stayed in the top 10 for 17 weeks, which apparently was a record at that time. I'm always interested in these kind of lawsuit things as well, and you know, if anything's been taken from another track. And as with the Wham Last Christmas Barry Manilow connection, there was actually one with this as well. And a guy called Ronald Sell sued the Bee Gees in 1983 because he'd done a demo, very, very kind of basic demo, and I've got it here. I'm just going to play you a couple of seconds of it. This is his original demo. Someone's put it up on YouTube. Here we go. I love the kind of RMI piano. I don't know if you guys know the RMI piano. But... what do you reckon?
I think Ronald might have a point.
He had a point, but unfortunately couldn't back it up with anything. Right. You know, it's you're meant to do that thing of if you write something, you're meant to put it in an envelope and send it to yourself so you can prove when you wrote it. Not that I've ever done that, but that's what you...
Yeah, get a pile of envelopes in your drawer. Any day now.
But he lost it, unfortunately. And, you know, a bit like Yvonne Elliman, you know, he could have been big. But anyway, so, you know, that's the background. So let's get to looking at the actual track. Now, I've got my favourite door, Ableton, and my favourite controller, Push, for this. And... I always kind of like to look for an acapella, and there aren't any kind of official acapellas around for this. I think there's like a Glee one, but I thought I'd steer clear of that, you know. But amazingly, I found a sort of live rare performance on the Des O'Connor show of the guys just kind of sitting on the sofa with a guitar, but then they play the track, and they just sing a verse and a chorus, and there's no accompaniment at all. And I've got it. I put it in the computer.
Perfect.
Here we go. And it needed a bit of work, to be honest, because obviously there was no click or anything, so it was, the time was all kind of was varying. And tuning-wise as well, it wasn't perfect, you know. So I've done a little bit of work in it in Ableton, and I've got it in here. So we should have a quick listen to that. Just take the metronome off.
I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring.
And that's there. That's BBC reverb on there.
Natural.
Yeah, natural reverb. I'm not sure what reverb it was, but so that's in there. And I just thought, yeah, let's kind of go up and go through it and build up the backing track around that, and then maybe we could look at a remix as well.
Maybe later, yeah.
Yeah, based on the chords and everything. So, first thing I'm gonna do is add the beat, and I just wanted to get a kind of acoustic-y type sounding kit. So I kind of went through the Ableton Live packs, the drum kits, and didn't really like that. Then I went into Native Instruments Battery, couldn't really find anything. And then I went to Logic and just found the Slow Jam kit in the Drum Kit Designer. And I just kind of bounced it down in individual hits and put it into Ableton Drum Rack, and sounds like that. So I thought I'd put that in. So let's go for it. I think we're good to go. The metronome's on. I've got quantize on at the moment, set to 16. So let's just put this beat in.
I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring
rain. Okay, so the metronome off. Okay, so I actually did, there's a kind of the bar before, so that's actually three bars. So I'm just going to put the clip on there, and in fact, let's just go into here. Okay, and I'm just going to set the loop start position to the second bar. So when we play this now, it'll just loop round those second two bars.
I feel you touch me in the pouring rain.
Cool. So we've got a beat going. I'm now going to move over to the keyboard. So the next kind of key sound in this is Fender Rhodes. I'm a massive fan of Fender Rhodes. I've got one. I've got an 88 key suitcase.
Nice.
Yeah. fortunately, I couldn't bring it in.
But no, it wouldn't fit.
When I want to recreate a Rhodes, I go to this in Contact, which is the Scarby Rhodes. Comes with complete. Oops. Let's just bring it up. Here we go. It's here, it's just down here. And I had this as a library sound when with the previous version of Contact, and it now comes with Complete 9, so it's brilliant. And it actually kind of comes with some controls like pan, compression, chorus, and it's got a phaser on as well. So let's just have a quick play. Kind of beautiful sound, you know.
Yeah,
it's one of the best Rhodes, kind of almost authentic Rhodes sounds that I've found. So so that's it. And I'm going to bring up the chords as well. Let's have a look here. So we can actually have a look to see what's going on. Here we go. And I've got my keyboard as well, my virtual keyboard. There we go. So we're in E flat for this, E flat major. Play that scale. C flat major. And the first chord is an E flat. So I quite a kind of chord heavy tune. But you know, really interesting chords. And you know, we in the EMC course, we look at defining chords on the degrees of the scale. So if we're in E flat major, this would be the one chord. Which is E flat, that's E flat triad here. A flat major triad, this would be the four chord, and the B flat major would be the five chord. So we can kind of go through these chords here. The first chord is an E flat, then it goes to a G minor seven, and we could say that's the three chord, and then it goes down to the F minor seven, which is the two chord. But then we get this interesting kind of deviation, the C7 here. If you remember, the notes of E flat major are these, but suddenly we've got an E natural in there. So we have to look at where it's going next, and it's actually going back to the F minor 7. So this movement here has like a 5-1 kind of movement, and it's used so much. We'll see it again in the chord sequence. It's a really good way of, especially with modulations, of getting into another chord. So I tell you what, I think what we'll do is I'll actually kind of record this down, recording the part. I'm hoping I'm going to be able to do it in one go. And I'll try to put the chords up at the same time. So anyone at home can maybe follow along, and we can have a look at it afterwards. So let's just bring the chords back up again. All right, here we go. It's going to be difficult.
I just want to say I'm really glad we got this far without mentioning your hair.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, didn't grow in like 2 weeks. Looks great though, by the way.
It's working, is it?
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, cool. All right, I'm just going to figure out a way of hitting record and then kind of hiding the screen at the same time, so you can actually see the chords. I think I can do it. So here we go. Let's go.
I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain. And the moment that you wander far from me, I want to feel you in my arms again.
Playing along?
And you come to me on a summer breeze. Keep me warm.
Love this chord here. D flat 9. G minor 7. Then we've got a nice slash chord here, going to the tonic, making it a major 7, A flat major 7, A flat minor 6. This is an interesting one here. Woo! Stays on this chord. There we go.
Nice.
Yeah.
Some of those chords are crazy, aren't they?
They're mad, aren't they? So, let's just, we've got that in there, and let's just bring these chords back. So, one I particularly like is this, which comes sort of at the end of a verse section or the kind of bridge section. And it's basically, because the root note here is a B flat, so it's acting like the 5 chord. Well, it is the 5 chord, but rather than being a straight kind of B flat, we've actually what I sort of term as a slash chord. So we've got the 4 chord, which is A flat major, over the B flat.
It's like 10 cc, isn't it?
It is. You know, get really kind of jazzy sound with that. But not only that, but they're making that a major 7 as well. So it's A flat major 7 over B flat. So it just works really nicely, kind of leading back to the E flat major for the chorus. We also have this chord here, which I mentioned was really nice, where it starts off the chorus of "How deep is your love" on the E flat major 7, and then goes to the 4 chord, but then here, and it's almost like a sort of diminished chord here. And again, it kind of, if we put the B flat, the 5 underneath that, it acts like a kind of 5-1 progression, but we've actually got the 4 there, so that's really nice. And then we've got this beautiful kind of step down as well, where we go the E flat, and this we've got a G minor 7, flattened fifth. The flattened fifth is this here, going down to C7, which is like the 5 chord back to the F minor 7. Flat. So have a play along. I mean, it's just so, when you're studying music theory, it's so great to kind of play along with tracks, you know. Yeah. Follow the chords and just kind of get an idea, because you know you can incorporate these chords into your own writing. You know, these are, in my opinion, there's not enough kind of pop writing these days.
Yeah.
with kind of such interesting chords.
Totally.
You know, so I think now we've got that down, we should look at the bass line. And let's just check that's in there.
I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain.
So one thing about this is that when I was playing it, I feel like I should be pushing the whole time, but I kept it very, very straight. I listened to the original. It's like every chord is like on the kind of one, you know, and the rhythm, kind of the syncopation in a way comes with the vocal. So. So we're going to look at the bass now, and the bass really follows the kick drum, and it also just follows the root of each chord as well. So it's that kind of thing. So I'm going to put that down now.
I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain, and the moment that
few passing notes in there. Go.
Perfect.
Don't know, yeah. I've been practicing.
I was just like totally just spaced out listening to that. So. That was amazing. I mean, it's the thing about those chords is like if you are just starting out or you want to learn how to like play and read music and stuff, they're quite difficult to learn by ear, those chords.
Yeah, and yeah. I just kind of typed in, you know, chords, how deep is your love, and they came up. But the thing is, there's a lot of different versions. There's like, you know, a lot of versions that are transposed to make it a bit easier. I don't think E flat's not the kind of easiest key, and especially for guitarists as well, where the bottom note, unless you kind of tune down, the bottom note is an E. It's not kind of so easy. So you kind of have to search around, and also sometimes the chords are simplified as well. So I think it's a combination of finding them, you know, and then listening as well. It's just a great way to understand music, you know, and to kind of develop your ear, you know, have that connection between your ear and actually, you know, seeing the notes in front
and
of you.
And you'll invariably spot some trends within other tracks then and go, oh, okay, now I get why they did that.
Well, you know, a simple thing when it comes to songwriting is that 5-1 progression. You know, you're kind of moving, you might be going to the one chord, the four chord, the two chord. It's like, okay, well, what chord can I use next to then get me back into the one chord, you know? So sort of just simple things like that. The more you can study, the better, you know. That was actually a native bass sound, the Boffner bass. I've used it so much. Used it on the Get Lucky Deconstruction I did, and it's a great sound. So it comes with live. So the next thing, listening to the track, is in the kind of the bridge section, which is here. To me on a summer. It feels like it kind of opens out a little bit, and it's got like some sort of synth pad. So I thought I'd enlist this, which is it's the Tal Uno LX, which
classic,
is like
a
classic, yeah. That's thoroughly worth buying.
That's, yeah, because they have a free version as well, don't they? They have a Juno 60 emulation.
Yeah. Yeah. This is the one, I bought this one, and I started off just with a brass pad, and then I sort of adapted it, you know. I wanted it to have sort of slightly less attack and more decay as well. Mm. So you can hear that the filter cutoff kind of like gradually kind of fades out. So what we can do with this is just bring this sort of, it's kind of like double the chords as it comes in. So it really kind of fills it out. So let's put that in. So that's sounding really nice.
It's amazing how live vocals make you forget that it's all this, that the drums aren't live and the keys aren't live, that they're all synthesized.
Yeah.
Because it sounds like a live band to me now.
Yeah. It's coming together. There's one more element, which is strings. So, it's a classic kind of arrangement technique is that, you know, when you get to the chorus, you just want to build it up, you know. Mm. Sometimes it works the other way around, and sometimes choruses are really kind of empty out, you know. But certainly with this, it's like a kind of gradual build up, you know, more and more kind of instrumentation is coming in. So if I just. How do you mean to love? Is your love? How deep is your love? So one thing that comes in here is strings. Pretty sure they were able to afford an orchestra for this, which is, we can't all do. So I'm using a standard core library Ableton string sound here. But rather than just playing the chords, When it comes to kind of strings, we can actually make it a bit more melodic. So if we look at the chorus, I'm just going to bring back these chords here. You can see it's got this A flat, major 7. And then we go to this chord here. I'm just going to get my chords back here. Hold on. Rather than just kind of playing the same chord, we can actually kind of rise up a little bit. So let's just put this in. Okay, just going to get rid of those chords. I'll just play along to practice for the moment. So we can go up here. You're going to get the idea. So let's put this in.
Sounds amazing.
Yeah, so that's pretty much it. You know, that's the sort of the core of the track. In this a cappella, I only got the verse and the chorus, right. So didn't get a second verse, unfortunately. I think that's all they had time for on the Des O'Connor show. But so yeah, that's the original track. Hopefully you can kind of refer back to this for the chords. Maybe we can make the chords available as well. You
know, yeah, totally. I mean, I think anyone who's in the process of learning piano, this is a great song to learn because it takes you that next level.
Yeah, totally. And of course, if you've got it in Ableton or Logic, with Ableton you can use warp, so you could kind of slow it down as well. So you don't have to sort of play it. This is at 106. But the next thing I wanted to do is to try a remix. It's like, how do we approach a remix of this? So this vocal is warped, and I've put it up to 126 BPM. let's just see what we've got here. I don't In order to do this, to sort of have like to work at two different tempos within the same project, I've used some tempo automation. So you can see here that it jumps up from 106. So as soon as we kind of go to the left-hand side of this this little jump here, we're at 106, and then we go to the other side of it, and it flips to 126 BPM. So let's just listen to what the a cappella sounds like. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain. Sometimes when you speed things up, you just don't know what it's going to, you know, how ridiculous
it works,
it's going to sound.
Though. It kind of has a rhythm to it.
I feel you touch me in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain.
So should we try a beat on it?
And yes, let's do it. In
the morning okay, sun. Here we go. I feel you touch a nice big kick here. Rain. Okay, let's go for it. And the rise in the morning sun. I think I went a bit out of time there. I was getting a bit carried away. I think
yeah.
It was your laughter actually. Sorry, did it? I'm not blaming you or anything, but okay.
I think it's great though. Keep going, yeah.
Maybe the probably a metronome would help. That often really helps, but keep you in time, doesn't it? Okay, here we go. Rise in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain. And the rise in the morning sun. Rise in the morning sun. Feel you touch me in the pouring rain. And the rise in the morning sun. I don't know if you've ever heard this kind of beat before, like four on the floor. I actually came up with it. And this kind of offbeat as well. It works really well. Okay, let's put this in.
It does work. And the rise in the morning sun. I feel you
touch me in the pouring rain. I mean, I don't really know what I'm doing as I'm programming it in. I'm just kind of really improvising. Let's try a sort of snare clap sound. Okay, should we try like an extra hat as well? Okay, let's go. Here we go.
I feel you touch me in the pouring rain.
Yeah.
And the rise in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the
sounding a little bit repetitive,
rain.
That vocal, isn't it? It's starting to annoy me.
A little bit.
Yeah. I think we need some music in here. Before we do that, I think we should swing this beat a little bit. Sounded far too straight for me. So I'm just holding down the quantize button here, and I'm just, as they like to say, dialing in some swing. Yeah, it's got a bit more of a groove now, hasn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. Now let's just double this. I'm really needing some more lyrics here. Here we go. So next up, I think we should go for some kind of bass line, and it seems very in vogue, the kind of MK, M1
kind
of organ bass sound.
Show Me Love classic.
Yeah, epic sound, and it's coming from my M1 plugin. So what I want to try to do with this is just to not, you know, as much as possible, not have to copy the chords, the original chords. But it's tricky because of the way that the vocal is written. It's very much kind of working with the chords, and there's sort of like weird modulations and stuff. So first thing I'm going to think about is the fact that we were in E flat major. I want to think of what the relative minor of that is, because that can often be a good place to start. So just remind you, the scale of E flat major is that. The relative minor we work out by going down three semitones. So E flat, D, 1, 2, 3. And we get C minor. So it might well be that I can kind of think in terms, or certainly for the verse anyway, of C minor rather than E flat, and that will give it a bit more of a kind of moody sound as well. So I'm just gonna sort of jam along a little bit and see what it sounds like. See on C there. Is that working? Okay, so I'm sort of for the second part of it, I'm kind of following the original chords by going to that F, G, and the B flat. But let's put that in, and then we can maybe build on top of that.
The octave jumps is like, yeah, exactly.
It just gives it a kind of bit of a funk, you know.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, I mean, it could, you know, an obvious thing would be to actually just play the chords over the top, but I'm thinking of trying to keep this verse section a bit moodier. So I'm going to bring up another recent purchase of mine. I never thought I'd buy it, but you know, we did the Academy of Electronic Music, and it seemed like the common currency of those guys was Silenth. And so, you know, yeah, I thought I'd better buy it to see what the fuss is about. And it's a great synth. I mean, it's obviously kind of associated with trance and EDM, whatever, but it's kind of great for some deep house sounds. And, you know, there's loads of, sort of flexibility with it as well. So I just sort of adapted one of the presets again. It's originally called Key Placo Bar. I think it had a sort of arpeggio sort of built into it. I took that away, and I just thought I'd kind of use this sound. So let's just bring up the keyboard again. Okay, and I'm going to go for like a kind of fifthy sound here. So when we say a fifth, it's we're thinking of in terms of the degrees of the scale. So just to talk about that. So, for example, we're in E flat major. This is our first note, and then this is the second. It's called a major second. This is a major third. This is a perfect fourth, and this is a perfect fifth. So, major sixth, major seventh, and then a unison or octave. So, I'm going to play fifths for this, and this is kind of a really good way to practice your scales and just your general kind of hand positioning on the keyboard is just to, rather than just kind of playing chromatically one note at a time, actually try and play the fifth above it at the same time. So you kind of do this thing. Obviously, you can program this in with a chord device or whatever, you know, chord memorizer, but it's just really good kind of practice to do. So I'm going to do this for this bass line. I'm just going to kind of echo the bass line that I was playing with these kind of fifths. So let's just play that in.
A lot of MK then.
Yeah. Hey man, the track got to number one. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, we want to make hits here. That's what it's all about. So let's look at the next section now. And I want to kind of follow on from the original arrangement. You know, I want to build this up because we've got that kind of verse. I'm thinking about this as the bridge. So let's lay down the bass on this. Because this the vocal is so intertwined to the chords, I'm just going to copy the chords here with the bass line. So let's just see where we're going up to. Okay, so we're going to go up to there. There we go. All right, let's just bring out the keyboard so you can see what I'm doing. There we go. Okay, so need to refer to the chords here. Okay, same thing, I'm going to go to that silent sound now as well and play the fifths over that. Make it a bit more rhythmic this time. That kind of vibe. Already you've got that kind of nice syncopation between the bass line and that. You know, I wasn't really thinking about what I was doing, but it's just, you know, sort of like randomness that's come up there. It's quite cool. So now I'm actually going to go back to this original sound, this Juno pad sound, because I think that's going to kind of really nice sort of space it out, give it some width. It
fills up that mid-range really nicely. The Juno always does that, yeah.
Yeah, sure. But rather than kind of having these like sevenths, I want to make it sort of a bit rougher, so I'm just going to really simplify these chords by just kind of keeping them as triads, this kind of thing. So let's just put that in. Still keep that chord in there because it's so nice. Might be nice to play around with the frequency cutoff and the resonance on this as well. Okay, so let's look at the chorus now.
Deep is your love, how deep is your love, I really mean to learn.
What I'm thinking with this is just rather than kind of having the second section, we could just make this a kind of like a repetitive chorus. So, let's just cut out that last bit there.
Yeah, someone in the comments, by the way, if you do have any questions, just stick them in the comments. But someone's asked, is that a wig? That's how realistic it is.
Incredible.
It's maybe, like suddenly they've just realised.
Maybe this should not be real. Look.
Yeah. You can keep it, it's fine.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so let's work on the chorus section now. I've just taken that bit out there.
Yeah.
So The original, in the original it goes to the E flat, which is the one chord, but I'm going to stick to the relative minor here and stick on the C. So we go to, yeah, it's like a C minor kind of vibe. And then just kind of step down to the sixth chord, seeing if we're thinking in terms of C minor now. So A flat, B flat, C. So let's just try this out. Go to the silent. Put that in. And let's put those chords in, really simple chords on this sound. And finally, just to top that off, I thought I'd go for this Inspector Norse lead sound.
Yes, the Norse.
The Norse, exactly. And you might have seen my deconstruction of that incredible track. And I actually created this just using the Ableton analog device with some effects. Let's just maybe get like a little riff to go over that. Something like that. So what we can do now, I always love doing this, is we can actually take out the a cappella and we've kind of got a new track. So, just quickly, before, I know the time is pressing on, but I've been working. I kind of put the beat just in this session mode here, but everything else I've been using the arrange mode. And what I love about Logic 9 now is we've got this function here, consolidate time to new scene. So what we can do is just highlight that. So I'm just highlighting this section. I just got rid of that for you. There we go. And if I just do consolidate time to new scene, what it then does is that puts that into session mode here and puts that onto a new scene. So I can then kind of play that. So let's just do that for the other sections as well. Let's just put this back here. Let's do the same thing. Consolidate time to new scene.
So you don't have to like manually drag everything like you did before.
Exactly, yeah. And you'll be able to see the benefit of this in a minute, just doing these three sections. So we've now got, if we go to session mode here, we can now actually play these. So we can work on our arrangement, so kind of really handy. So yeah. That's the original track, and I just sort of on the fly remix, which will be available in your shops in 10 years'
Perfect
time.
Perfect Valentine's gift.
Yeah, exactly.
If you're running late. Yeah.
Exactly.
You don't need flowers.
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, man, that was amazing. We're just about out of time, so that was perfect timing.
Okay.
So good. So yeah, thanks a lot for that, Ski. I mean, that was magical. I think there's going to be a lot of, it's going to be a lot of serenading tonight now that everyone knows the chords for that song.
Yeah, I hope so.
Thanks a lot for tuning in again, and make sure you head over to our YouTube channel to watch our brand new Roland Era videos. And of course, hit the subscribe button, and we'll be back next week at our new time of 1 p.m. Cheers.